So I'm just getting back from the storage shelter because I'm going pheasant hunting tomorrow, and I had to pick these three things up. First up, this here, Prandelli Gasparini Gardone VT made in Italy. Then up here it says ACCIAIAIO special SIAU. It's 20 gauge. It holds 2 3/4 and 3-inch shells. This one here is, let's see here, 12 gauge, 2 3/4 only, 28-inch barrel, high strength chromium steel. Over here, P. Beretta Gardone VT, made in Italy. The Garcia Corporation, Washington, D.C. Probably who imported it. And BL4 on the bottom. Nice trap gun, upland gun. Oh, I forgot. Bottom here. Just has a little, like a cross or something. It looks like, I don't know, but if you could see it without the reflection from the light or anything. Okay, whatever. This one here, this is mine. This is the missing ring. The reason why I call it the missing ring is because the bottom here, if you could see, there's like an angel or something holding the missing ring for the Olympic rings. Then there's like a knight at the top of a shield, and on there it says Orm's Ammunition, but right here that's what this is, a PIE Tro Beretta, Silver Snipe 12 gauge, has the little Beretta symbol there. Oh yeah, and on the bottom down there it says monoblock. But yeah, some clothes. Just a nice pair of jeans. Not a nice pair, but a, you know, a knock around pair. And smoking at an early age, saving up my Marlboro miles, got me this jacket. I also got a red school bag with it, but I use this for upland hunting. And I was at Dick's Sporting Goods and picked up this vest here. This vest is awesome. I mean, it holds 5 shells down in them, that little like pouch thing there. Then you got the same thing here, but only 4 shells. And the same on the other side, right here. I've stuck a pair of gloves in there. 4, and then the 5 there. This is a Master Sportsman's vest, and what I like about it is I can access the game bag by just sticking my hand down through the front of me and coming over to the game bag, or I can also access it from the back here. But the good thing about it, to clean it, you can just unzipper it and you get to clean it. So I mean, like, I can stick all my licenses and stuff into this. Oh, I almost tried on it. I went to a Phillies game and picked up a hat for $40, a blaze orange hat. Allows me to wear it, so I can wear it when I'm hunting. Now this hunt's going to be on film, and it'll be from, I don't know, one of 3, maybe 4 different cameras. Right here is the iCam Extreme. These are the newer model. I had the older model. It was in camouflage, but something happened with it, and the factory that makes them told me send it back, and they said they were out of the ones I had, and they sent me these for free. So I just pulled the lenses out so I could see better out of them. And what I'm using right now to film this, I have 2 of these. It's a drift cam. They have remote controls for them. So, you know, when I got a dog, and when he goes on the point, I could just press, you know, record, and it'll start to record. And, I mean, it's very good camera. There's, I think, I don't know if there's Zoom on there or not, but my mistake was here. Went to Walmart and seen these shells. All right, so I picked them up. All I seen was 12 gauge, 2 and 3 quarter, 13, 25, shot 7. Said they're great. Went to the skeet range, opened them up. I said, oh man, they're low. They're low. But they got the speed, so I'm not worried about it. So I'm wondering why I'm only, 15 out of 25. The next 2 hours, I went again, 13 out of 25. So I'm sitting there, I picked up the shells and I seen this. Yep, steel shot. Steel shot doesn't pattern well. So I said, all right. So if I'm going to go hunting, I'm going to need to pick up shells. So I was looking for these. These are the 20 gauge, 3 inch. I was looking for these, and they only had 3 inch. So I picked up these. It said 1350 feet per second, 3.5 drams, 2 and 3 quarter inches, shot size 7.5. Okay, another thing, well, but lead shot. It's not steel. So it should pattern. So I picked up 2 boxes of these, actually. In the one box I went to the skeet range with, and I hit, I think, 20 out of 25. Somewhere like that. And I got these 12 gauge. I like using these, but these aren't mine. These are somebody else's. 12 gauge, 6 shot. 1330. These are perfect. Pheasants, doves, rabbits. So, on this, it just has shot 7, just has doves. This has nothing on there. These, they have everything. It's, shows you. FS lead, it has a pheasant on there. So, I don't know. I'm getting my dog. Going to be going to bed. I'm going to be letting my dog out, and I don't know. Keep watching. Hopefully, my dog could smell some birds out there.
The mount that I'm using for the camera is just basically the mount that came with the camera. I turn it sideways like this here, and sits on the side of my shotgun up at the front. It also acts as a weight, which I really like. And back a while ago, I was using a JVC camera with, 60 power zoom and everything. So I bought a camera mount that could go on my bow, shotgun, or rifle by Deerage Innovations. And this is the strap that came with it. That's also a very good mount. I picked this up with the camera, and I said, this came with the camera mount. So what I do is I could fit this down in my vent rib there and have it go around my camera. And the good thing, these drift cams is their remote control. So when my dog goes on point, I could just hit the play button. And record, and start recording. So these are the shells I'm using. These are the 3 shotguns, and that's it. Before you keep watching, we'll be out there and see my dog in action.
Flash it. Get him. But I don't know where it's at. Flush it. Get him. I see it. Flush it. Go ahead. Flush it. Let it go. Get him up, bud. Get in there, get him, bud. Get him, bud. Get him.